Hello students, this is your computer teacher Devdeep sir, back with another lesson of computer for you all. Now, today we are going to discuss chapter number 4, that is files and folder in Windows 7, okay? We are going to do a brief recapitulation of this chapter, that is chapter number 4, files and folders in Windows 7, okay? So for that all of you, turn to page number 24. Page number 24 is that particular page where you have to turn to. Now, what we can do here, you can save your work in files and folders in a very easy way. Alright, so whatever work that we do on our desktop, we can save that easily in our files as well as that of folders. Okay, now, see the next line. All the work that we do on a computer is stored in the form of what? It is stored in the form of file. Okay, so this is an important thing, that all the work that we do in a computer, it is stored in form of what? It is stored in form of a file. Alright, now that file contains, now this file can contain anything. It can be a text file, it can be a picture file, it can be a sound file also. So these are the basically the different categories of file. It can be a text, it can be a picture file, it can be a sound file, etc. Now each file, each of this file has its unique name. So every file must have a unique name, otherwise it will become duplicate with each other. And sometimes if all the files have the same name, they can get replaced by each other. Okay, so that is why each file must have unique name. Otherwise, what will happen if there is no unique name? We do that so that there is no duplicate file. Okay, we do that because in order to avoid any duplicate file. Your computer represents files with icons. So each of the files are also represented by the help of what? They are represented by the help of its individual icons. Okay, now there are separate icons for document, for spreadsheet file, for image file, and even audio and video file. So is there any doubt in this page? Please let me know in the chat box in your WhatsApp group if you have any doubt in this particular page. Okay, so I'll wait for you. Please mark all this data there. Mark all the important lines that have been given. Okay, now we come to the next topic, that is folder. A folder is a location for organizing our files. So what is a folder? Folder is a location where we are organizing our files. Okay, so a group of files can be stored together under a common name called folder. So folder is a location where we organize all the files, that means different document files in a separate documents folder, all the music files in a separate folder. So folder is basically a location in our computer where we are organizing the file, and folder must also have unique name, otherwise again that issue will be there, that duplicate copies of different folders. Okay, now inside the folder also we can contain additional folder. Inside the folder also there can be many folders or additional folders. If a folder is containing an additional folder, what is that folder called? That additional folder, that additional folder is called subfolder. Imagine your folder, concept of folder in that of a this, okay, that is called an office cabinet. So if suppose this is the main folder, okay, imagine that this is a main folder that we have, okay. In this folder itself, see how many folders are there. So these are called the subfolders, okay? Whereas the main thing is the folder, alright? Now, viewing files and folders, we can get different files and folders in our different areas, okay? So, whenever we want to create and save a document, where we can save that? In our documents folder. So, any form of document, where we can save that? We can save it in the documents folder. So, whenever we want to save any picture, okay? Whenever we want to save any picture, alright, from digital camera or scanner or internet, where we can store that? We can store it in the pictures folder. So whenever we want to store any form of picture, where we can store that? We can store that in the pictures folder, okay? Whenever you want to download any music file, it gets stored where? It gets stored in the music folder, okay? So for saving any form of music, where we can save that? In the music folder. Whenever you want to download any video file, where we can store that? We can store that in the videos folder, okay? So, any form of documents, documents folder, any form of pictures, pictures folder, any form of music in the music folder, any form of video in the videos folder, okay? Now, we can also access them by clicking on the computer icon. What is this computer icon called? Since junior class you have known it by a name. What is that name called? It is called My Computer. Basically inside the My Computer there are all the local disk. Inside this local disk also, if we want, we can store our data. So inside the local disk also, if you want, the data can be stored, okay? Now see, the moment we click on My Computer, okay, these are the CD-ROM drive or the DVD drive, okay, that are present. Basically, these are the partition of hard disk. Okay, these are the partition of the hard disk. Now, what is the meaning of partition? Partition means segment or part. That means if our hard disk is a 1 TB, you all are having a 1 TB hard disk, you can store 1 TB data in different local disk if you want. Okay, and separately you will also get, like particularly in desktop and laptops, we also get a DVD-ROM drive or a DVD writer, where we can even store data in the form of DVDs or CD. Okay, understood? Is it clear or not? Now, as I told you, we can store any form of documents in the document folder. So, in order to open the document folder, what we have to do? Double click it. Okay, so for opening the documents folder, you have to double click it. And the moment you double click it, you will see this kind of screen appearing, okay? So this is the screen that will appear. This is the documents. This is the view of the documents folder, okay? Inside this, all the documents are present. Now, the name of the folder whose contents you are viewing appears at the end of the file path, okay? So, all the documents that we are viewing, it appears at the end of file path. This is the end of file path. You can see the last name. This is the end of file. Now, what is the meaning of a path? See, a path is a route that the user must follow to reach a particular folder. So, the pathway to a particular folder. Pathway means the collection of directories to a particular folder. That means, see, this is a path. See, user, from user folder we go to documents. Okay. So, this becomes a path. From local disk C drive, you have to go to user folder. From user folder, you have to go to document. This is an example of a path. Okay? Clear or not? Okay, so path is clear. Path is a route for of the user to reach to a particular folder or document. Okay, now basically what is the use by which particular software we can view all the files, like all of you have seen Android phones now. In Android phones we have file manager. So in Windows, what do we have? We have the Windows Explorer, which is the file manager of Windows. So Windows Explorer is used for viewing files and folders of the Windows operating system. So how we can see what are the uses of Windows Explorer? It is very helpful for efficiently organizing files and folders. So I told you now, file manager. Windows Explorer is acting as a file manager. So it is used for managing all the files that are present inside the Windows operating system. Okay. So how we can go to the Windows Explorer? Let us see the steps. First, we can click on the start button. From the start button, we can go to all programs. From all programs, you have to go to accessory, and from accessory, we have to go to Windows Explorer. So I repeat the step. Step 1, go to start button. Step 2, click from the start button, click on all programs. Inside the all program, go to accessories and then click on Windows Explorer. Okay. Now, Windows Explorer, when it comes in two different panes, the left pane and the right pane. Okay. What does the right pane contain? Right pane contains the details. Okay. Details of the file. And the left pane contains the menu or the navigation point. Navigation pane is used for moving through different options of file. Navigation pane is used for moving through different files. Okay. So it is used for moving through different files. And menu control is used for displaying the different menus. So display menu. Okay. So these are the things that you have to remember, and if possible, mark with pencil inside your book. Now the moment we click on any of this menu, there will be two signs. These two signs, okay? This one that you can see, when the sign will change to this, okay? This is called the expanding sign. So this is called the expanding sign. That also means, this sign means that the folder contains subfolder. Okay. Now, if you have finished viewing, we can go back to the folder, main folder, or collapse. Okay. Using the collapse sign. Collapse means to go back to the parent folder. That means, suppose there is a folder called ABC. Inside the ABC folder, there is DEF and GHI, two folders. So we will use the expand sign to move to this two folder. And again, in order to go back to ABC, we will use what sign? We will use the collapse sign. Okay. Understood how it is working? Okay. Now I have some homework questions for you that you have to solve. First question, what is the file? Second question, what is a folder? What are, third question, what are the different types of file? Fourth question, question number four, Question number 4 is, what are subfolders? And question number 5, what is Windows Explorer? What is its use? What is what is its use? Okay, so these 5 questions you have to do it in your computer copy, and you have to submit the copy following the copy submission routine. Okay, so follow the
your Zook Rocker is ready to pair.
Follow the copy submission routine.
The wireless device has connected successfully.
So you have to follow the copy submission routine to submit the assignment. Okay, understood? So this was the question that will be your homework. Okay, so you have to do it in the computer copy and follow the copy submission routine to submit. All right, with this we come to an end of today's lecture. I hope you have understood this. Thank you and have a nice